First, I'd like to thank everyone for sending in such excellent questions over the past couple of weeks, and particularly those former students and those users of the Weather Underground. I appreciate your comments. I'm going to try to answer a few of them at least here today. And I'll start with a question from Elizabeth and Andy. They and a number of people want to know whether tornadoes are going to get worse in the future. Now, it'd be difficult for me to forecast in future years how many tornadoes we'd be getting. Our suspicion is that the change in tornadoes is more to do with natural variations than it is to do with climate change. That said, we do worry that the increased temperatures in the oceans of the Gulf of Mexico could be leading to increased amounts of moisture in the atmosphere, which obviously could lead to more thunderstorm formation and then potentially more tornado formation. But beyond that, there is no evidence at the moment that climate change is in any way related to increased numbers of tornadoes. Another question, a number of people are asking about how come Michigan is spared so often. I will remind you that until the tornadoes this year, Michigan was had the deadliest tornado event in Flint in 1954. But we've been largely spared, and it's because the conditions which are required for tornado formation usually don't occur in Michigan. You have to have a very unstable atmosphere, you have to have wind shear in the atmosphere, and you have to have these trigger moments in the atmosphere. Those are more likely to happen in the Great Plains, they're more likely to happen in the South, and fortunately we don't get those conditions all that often. There's a concern also from Brooke, who wanted to know whether Michigan, Lake Michigan, actually kills off tornadoes or thunderstorms. And there really isn't evidence that the lake is going to decrease the number of thunderstorms. The lake actually is a source of moisture. It can increase thunderstorm formation under certain conditions, decrease it under other conditions. So it's not obvious that the thunderstorms are more or less in Michigan because of Lake Michigan. Now we have some questions here asking about, here's one from A2 Girl, I love this name. How is it a tornado can go through a town and wipe out a whole building or buildings and yet leave certain things untouched? Well, that's simply luck of the draw. Inside the larger tornadoes, there are multiple suction vortices moving around the outer wall. It's possible one of them can pass and hit the house next to you, and it's possible that your house could pass through the tornado without being touched by these suction vortices, and you could have less damage or no damage in some situations. But that's highly, highly unlikely, and you just have to be really, really lucky that day. Other questions here about the green color. Does the green color in a thunderstorm indicate the storm means business? Well, the answer is certainly yes. The green color, we're not quite sure what causes the green color. It could be that the sunlight passing through that huge cloud is segregated into various colors, and all that's left would be the darker, greener colors. Other theories are that the only light that could make it onto the bottom of the cloud in a huge thunderstorm is actually reflected off the surface, and so you'd have the green grass color being reflected onto the cloud from beneath. We're not sure which is the answer, but certainly we know that these large clouds do produce that green color, and you won't get that green color unless the cloud is large and very active. More questions here about from John and Lawrence, for example, what types of climate change should we expect in the future, and how would that affect extreme weather? As I mentioned, tornadoes, we're not sure that the number of tornadoes should increase in the future. We do believe the number of reported tornadoes have gone up, largely because there are more people reporting. In terms of hurricanes, there is legitimate concern of the number of hurricanes and or the intensity of hurricanes may increase in the future, because the formation of a hurricane is entirely a function of how warm the ocean is. And if you have more ocean that's warmer, then there's more opportunities for these storms to organize and grow over time. So there is legitimate concern that the number and strength of hurricanes may increase in the future as the oceans warm. Can you tell whether global warming has increased the north-south temperature gradient, Randy asks. to the point where tornado favorable conditions could be created? We don't know, Randy. We know that the north-south temperature gradient should be getting less because the polar regions are warming up faster than the tropics, and that would decrease the temperature gradient from south to north, and that could affect the strength of the jet stream, and that could have an impact on thunderstorm formation. But beyond that, it's pure speculation at this point. I want to thank you all for your questions. These are superb questions, and if you have more, please feel free to email me, samson@umich.edu. I'd be happy to give you my answers. Thank you.